Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again. And today I'm coming with, how you call that? That massive making or mass making. I think it's called mass making. When you gonna do more than one piece or two pieces. I'm making those trick or treat. I'm still not sure if I'm saying that right. Trick or treat Halloween bags. And I'm making it for our local kids. I've been visiting our local shop and we decided for this year to do like outside decoration because of that all that COVID situation. It's kind of risky still to, you know, to go out and visit so many families. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna a little bit decorate all road and the next road with those parents and our local shop owner. And I'm gonna prepare bags and he will fill it with something. That's what we decided. So I need to find something easy to do, but looking kind of interesting, something a little bit different than you can find in shops. But hopefully kids will like, and because it's for kids, it can be too much grungy and, you know, that style I like. So I was thinking I need to do it in style I like, but for kids. For that, I think this mummy, it's just perfect. So I decide that he's like stepping on this scared pumpkin. And from other side, I've got this trick or treat. And as usual, it's made from envelope. And because it's not too hard to make it, I'm gonna show you how you can make it. Here I made one in black, so I know I will do half-half. And we will, you know, somehow put it on the rope. That one white, one black, one white, one black. And kids will choose which they will like. So it's not hard to make it. You will need a long envelope, DL envelope. Why my camera? It's making those stupid things. I'm so sorry. So, one DL envelope. I'm gonna glued that envelope all together. I'm gonna make sure that everywhere it will be nice and sticky. So I'm gonna add a little bit more glue here on those edges. And here, where there it's not that sticky strip. And I'm gonna show you that white one. That black one, it's just when I glue it all together before I add those, that mummy and pumpkins and those ropes around. I just painted with black acrylic paint. That was all. So I've got this envelope. I'm gonna fold it half. So from one envelope you will have two bags. And I'm using also dies. Basic Sizzix. Sizzix big dies. These tombstones, pediments. Oh, it's called pediments. Please zoom. I'm sorry for that shaking. It's called pediments, and here you've got the number of these dies, and it will cut those shapes for you. If you don't have this die, it's not too hard to make it. You will need some paper.
Do I have some paper?
I've got tons of papers around me, but
not right now. How is that possible?
So you will just need some paper. Fold that paper half. Take a pencil. With your pencil, just draw a half of your how is that name? Not tombstone. Something. Pediment. Oh, okay. Pediment. Just half of it. Like you would like to have it. Just this one. And then take your scissors. Cut it out. Of course, make sure that you have some nice, you know, some nice pattern. Some nice template which you will like. Here is just, you know, I'm gonna show you. And this will be like your template, and you can draw it, you know, on pictures, on paper, not on pictures, on paper. So you can make your own shaped. So I've got folded that envelope. I'm gonna cut it half. So I've got two small bags. Here and here. I'm gonna take my scoring board. And I'm gonna score. I'm gonna work just with one, but it will be for all of them same. So score these three lines, not that these three sides, not that side which is open, but those other sides. I'm gonna score them 5/8 of inch. 5/8 of inch, 5/8 of inch, and 5/8 of inch. Then fold those score lines. I'm gonna take my bone folder and make sure that it's nice and... What is that right word? Nice and crispy. What's the right word? Burnst. You know what I mean. Fold it nicely so you can find that fold properly when you will need so. Then open that pocket, put your hand in and start to spread those sides and kind of fold it. It will automatically navigate you to do the triangle from this end. So then fold that end inside, one and opposite one, and try to fold these inside here. The opposite side inside and this, and carefully press it together, and you have the base of your back done. So you will have back like this. Then I already pre-cut those pediments. I'm gonna put a glue here on the top. And I'm gonna glue that top on the top. Pediment on the top. And I'm using, you know, the light which is coming through to that paper to make sure that it's kind of straight. So once you have glued one side, flip it over and do other side. And here I can just copy, you know, to follow those lines on the top. The first one I tried to do without cheesecloth and it looks like this, but I do like it much more with the cheesecloth around. It gives to that super simple layout a little bit more that Halloween feeling, especially here when it's black. I like those black. So what you gonna do next is get your cheesecloth. I will put down link for the the measurement, the more informations about cheesecloth I am using. It's grade 90. If you wanna know, it's grade 90. I finally do remember that. I have to find, there was some comment. I forgot who left that comment in the past. I know one lady helped me with that. She also left a link, I think 3 videos back. She left a link. Thank you so much for that. You'll have to find that comment. I'm quite behind to answering all your comments. I'm so sorry for that. But I will get there, I promise. So take a piece of cheesecloth and try to glue it on the top. And more you will rip those edges, the better it will look. So I'm gonna take my poking tool. And I think this is a really beautiful idea. That was, you know, spread the moment idea when we spoke about Halloween. And I told him that, oh, I like to do some decorations for Halloween. I don't know Halloween too much because we never celebrate that Halloween. But I do like to do, you know, decorations. And he said, can you do bugs? I said, of course I can do bugs. That was funny. Funny conversation. So, we've got one side and the other side. And now I remember I forgot to distress it. So, I guess I'm gonna do the black one. Because I forgot. Oh my. See, I'm talking and I forgot. Just flip those edges. And guys, I'm learning now. One dance, it's called Jerusalem. Have you heard that yet? It's amazing song, a really beautiful song. I shared a few weeks ago a video with those African kids. They are dancing on that song. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. That song is gorgeous. Those kids. Oh my. I wanna have that move. So I'm learning that dance. It's so funny. I'm learning when morning with my dog when we are on the walk. I'm listening to that song and I'm trying the dance. So try to imagine my dog who has a problem still with his leg, so he's a little bit climbing or limbing, what is that right word? And me trying to learn the dance. We look like from mother house. I do have it flipped off. So because I forgot to distress it. When I do this kind of white one, before I glue down the cheesecloth, I'm taking the walnut stain distress ink and I'm distressing all those edges. It's easy to do. But because I forgot, I'm gonna take a painting. I'm gonna take black acrylic paint. And I'm gonna use black acrylic paint all over of this pocket. I will dry it and I will come back once it's dry. So I did paint all that pocket or back a little bit inside as well. I'm gonna take now Yuta string. I do have prepared few strings here. And I tried that with tacky glue, but with tacky glue it's just, you know, too long time. So I'm gonna take my heating tool, hot glue gun. Oh, you know what I mean, right? And I'm gonna glue it with hot glue gun. And just like this. And here I've got a little bit more than I need. Because it will be on all same. I'm gonna put two here and here. Like this. And two pieces across on those sides. One here. And one here. Hey, that was that welder's shape in the hand. That was what made me good welder while ago. Because I had that shake in my hand. This is a little bit longer. Okay, I've got one side. I'm gonna do the other side as well. Same way. Oops. If I will have a glue, I will do that. One on the bottom. I hope you are all well. I hope you have a wonderful weekend. It's gorgeous outside, so we've been today just for a short time with Sam in the big district to try him how much he can hold, you know, on his leg. It's not good yet. He can't walk too long time. He was good for 1 hour, but then he was too tired, so we went home. But it's getting a little bit better. It's not perfect, his leg, yet. But it's getting a little bit better. You need to do that step by step. Do not harsh on him. Do not rush, not harsh. Rush on him. And Peak District, it's a kind of park. They call it that national park. It's those... you can see that in Sherlock Holmes movies with Baskerville. That empty space with small hills. It's like park. And it's beautiful. It's really beautiful. So we've been there. I like that space there. Kind of lowland, even there are hills, but lowland-ish. There are some hills, but not too big. So this is the base. Now I'm gonna make two holes. I'm gonna take my ruler and I'm gonna measure. I showed that ruler before. This ruler has a middle. In the middle, 0, and then it's going to 7 inches, 7 inches, or 19 centimeters. So it's good to find, you know, from the middle, same spot on both sides. So I'm gonna measure where is the middle, and here, hopefully, I will see that 1, and here another 1. I hope I will see that. And this ruler, it's from EK Tools, EK Success Tools. I'm gonna make those holes using 1/8 inch on crocodile paper punch. And I do have here another Utah string, a little bit longer, and I'm gonna make handles for this bag. So I'm gonna open it, and I'm gonna go inside. Hopefully, go there. You are not going there. Why you are not going there? Go there. Go. One side, and other side. And I'm gonna make knot here. And tight it. Same I'm gonna do from that opposite side to make 2 handles, of course. One here, and one here, and oh, come on, and tie it together, and now just small decorations. Like this. So we have handles and small back for those goodies, for some sweets. And now just some decoration. So I've got here number 31, trick or treat, and this pumpkin, and of course mummy. I will have the, not that mummy, I can't offer you that mummy, but I do have sheet with that 31 number, those facey pumpkins and those pumpkins. I do have one sheet. It's for free if you are planning to do more gift bags for Halloween. And if you like this design, you can download that sheet from the crafts to inspire. It will be there to download it, but you have to be member of that group. It's Facebook group. I will put link down below, or you can download it from my Patreon for free. There will be down below in the description box, there will be also link for that post. What you've got here? I'm gonna leave it there. So I'm gonna put glue on the mummy guy. I'm so happy I can use him. I'm really happy I can use him because he's so cute. And I hope that kids will like him as well, mummy guy, who wants to step on pumpkin. And a little bit here. I forgot to put the pumpkin first. So my scared pumpkin. Glue and place him right here, I guess, like this. And now my mummy, and place him this way, like he wants to step on that pumpkin. And here on that number 31 and the trick or treat pumpkin, I'm gonna make a hole here in that, not sure how you call this top of that pumpkin. It's not branch, it's something different. So I do have holes. I need two more Utah strings to match it all together. Number 31, I'm gonna hang from the front of that of that bag, I mean, where the mummy is, and the trick or treat, I'm gonna hang on that opposite side to have some interest there, to not make it plain. And that's all my sharing for today. It's just mass production, guys, mass production. I'm not gonna make too many. I think about 50. Thing. So one is here, and trick or treat will be here on that opposite side. But even 50 is quite a lot. I'm gonna distress a little bit those edges because I fussy cut out with that white cardstock around. Like this. And through the pumpkin, make a knot. Come on. And hang it somewhere here, around this handle. So all informations, number of that die, also links for this free downloads, and also more information about the cheesecloth I'm using will be in the description box below. I forgot to tell you measurement of my envelope, but I think it's not as much important because, you know, you can do it from any kind of envelope, I guess. This envelope has 8 3/4 by 4 1/4. So that's the envelope I used. And this is my sharing for today. I hope you enjoy it. I hope you've got a lovely weekend. Take care about yourself. Don't forget to still keep the protection and still keep safe yourself. Have a wonderful day and see you next time. Bye.